Good morning to all. My name is Bhupendra Reddy. I am working as assistant professor in Chemical Engineering College. Now I am going to give a small demo on functions of several variables. Functions of several variables. So first I will discuss what is the function of single variable, y is equal to f of x. Function of single variable, y is equal to f of x, where x is the independent variable, y is the dependent variable. The y is a function of single variable x. Here in case of z is equal to f of x comma y. So here x comma y are independent variables and the z is dependent variable. So here z is a function of two variables. So it is called the function of single variable and this is the function of two variables. Simply it is called the function of two or more variables. It is called the function of several variables. So here I will discuss the differentiation of the function of several variables. Before that, what is the differentiation of the function of single variable? Here the rate of change of independent variable y with respect to the x is called the differentiation of y with respect to x. It is denoted by the dy by dx. Here we have d represents, it is a ordinary differentiation. It is called the ordinary differentiation. Here the rate of change of dependent variable with respect to the only one independent variable, that is called ordinary differentiation, that we can represents by small d. Okay, so in case of functions of two variables, here the rate of change of dependent variable with respect to the independent variable will be exist. So in case of z is equal to f of x comma y, here there are two independent variables are there. So the rate of change of dependent variable z will be exist with respect to x as well as with respect to y will be exist. So the rate of change of dependent variable z will be exist with respect to x is denoted by the dou z by dou x. Similarly, the rate of change of dependent variable z will be exist with respect to y is, that is dou z by dou y. Why here the dou represents, it is a partial differentiation. Here actually the z is a function of two variables, but we are calculating the differentiation with respect to the only one independent variable, not complete two variables at a time. Partially we are using, that's why it is called the partial differentiation. Okay? So here with respect to x differentiation we are calculating when in the case then there is no change in the y. So dou z by dou y represents the rate of change of z with respect to the independent variable y. So here I will discuss the partial differentiation concept of the functions of two variables. Functions of two variables. So here dou z, here the rate of change of independent variable z we are performing with respect to x and with respect to y one time. These two are called the first order partial differentiation. These are denoted by the small p and this is denoted by the small q. Small p is dou z by dou x. Small q is dou z by dou y. These two are called the first order partial differential operators. So if we perform the differentiation of this dependent variable z with respect to x two times, that is called the dou by dou x of dou z by dou x. Already we completed the with respect to x one time. So second time also we are performing with respect to x, that is equal to dou square z by dou x square, that I can denote by the small r. So here two times we are performing the differentiation of dependent variable with respect to x. See, two times differentiating the dependent variable with respect to the independent variable, here two variables are there. So here three possibilities will come. Say two times we can perform the differentiation with respect to first variable x two times, or with respect to second variable two times, or one time first variable with respect to first variable and second time with respect to the second variable y. So here all is the equal to dou square z by dou x square is 2 times differentiation of z with respect to the x. That we can denote by the r. Suppose if we perform the dou by dou y of dou z by dou x. Already we performed the partial differentiation of z with respect to x once. First variable. Next we are going to perform the partial differentiation of the z with respect to second variable y. That I can write dou square z by dou y dou x. That I can denote it by the yes. One time x, one time with respect to y. First time with respect to x and second time with respect to y. Here you may get the doubt, sir, which order we are following here? If first with respect to x, then with respect to y. If we perform first with respect to y, then with respect to x, what we get? That is dou by dou x of dou z by dou y. That is nothing but dou square z by dou x dou y. Here first with respect to y, we can perform the partial differentiation of z. Then next with respect to x, we can perform. That is equivalent to dou square z by dou x dou y. In any order, we can get the same answer, same value. So s is equal to dou square z by dou y dou x or dou square z by dou x dou y. Finally, we can write s is equal to dou square z by dou y dou x or dou square z by dou x dou y. We can write in any order, we can get the same value. So if we perform the differentiation with respect to one variable y two times, that is dou square, that is dou by dou y of dou z by dou y, that is equal to dou square z by dou y square, that I can represent small r. So now here r, so this is the t, sorry, this is the t. So now r, s and t, these three notations are second order partial differential operators. R ka p comma q are first order and r comma s comma t are second order partial differential operators. So same concept we can extend to third and higher order also. So this is about the partial differentiation of a function first and second orders. Now I will go for the how to find out the maximum and minimum of functions of two variables. Now I am going to explain how to find out the maximum and minimum value of maxima and minimum values of functions of two variables. Functions of two variables. So before going to explain how to find out the maximum and minimum of functions of two variables, roughly I will explain how to find out the maximum and minimum value in case of functions of single variable. Suppose f of x is equal to 0 is a function of single variable. To find out the for what value of x that f of x gets the maximum and for what value of x the function f of x gets the minimum value. So for that we have to find out the first order derivative f dash x. First we have to find out the first order derivative and equal to 0. Find equal to 0. Then we have to find out the second order derivative. Okay. So here by integrating the first order derivative, we can find out the stationary points. We can find out the points. That is value of x. The points are called the stationary points. For each stationary point, for what value of this stationary point, if f double dash x, f double dash x is less than 0 at the stationary point, if f double dash x is less than 0, that point is called the maximum point. Mean that value of x is maximum point. and the value of f of x at that point is called the maximum value. Maximum point, maximum value. If f double dash x is greater than 0, then the value of x is called the minimum value, minimum point, and minimum value. Same concept we have to explain to functions of two variables also. Suppose if we want to find out maximum or minimum value of the functions of two variables z is equal f of x comma y. See, here two x comma y are two independent variables. Z is a dependent variable, that z is a function of two variables. Here what we are doing, we are performing the first order derivative and equal to 0. From that we can get the stationary points. At each stationary point we have to check that the second order derivative is positive or negative. Depending on that we can decide that is a maximum or minimum. Here also same concept will be exist. Same concept also we have to discuss. So first we have to find out, step 1, first we have to find out the first partial derivatives of first and second order derivative p comma q comma r comma f comma t. Where what is the p? P is equal to dou z by dou x, or we can write dou f by dou x also. Depending on the given function we can use dou z by dou x or dou f by dou x. Simply we have to find out the partial differentiation of the given function with respect to x. Next we have to find out the q, that is dou f by dou x. So dou f by dou y we have to find out. Partial differentiation of y with respect to f with respect to y we have to find out. And also we have to find out second order partial differentiations, dou square f by dou x square comma dou square f by dou x dou y comma dou square f by dou y square we have to find out. Okay, these two are the first order partial differentiations. These r comma f comma t are second order partial differentiations. So after finding the all these first and second order partial differentiations, next in the step 2 we have to find out the stationary points by equating p is equal to 0 and q is equal to 0. We have to find out the stationary points. We have to find out the stationary points by equating p is equal to 0 one equation, and by taking q is equal to 0 second equation. By solving that we can get the values of x comma y. That points are called the stationary points. So simply in the step 2, by equating p and q is equal to 0, we have to find out the stationary point. Let the stationary points are a1 comma b1, a2 comma b2, and so on. Depending on the degree of given function we can get the number of stationary points. So in the step 3 we have to verify at each stationary point that point is either maximum or minimum, or neither maximum or neither minimum we have to verify. So at each stationary point we have to verify the conditions. What are the conditions at each stationary points? First we have to find out the r comma s comma t. At each stationary point we have to find out the r comma s comma t values. Here r comma s comma t are functions. By giving the x values and corresponding y values, then we can get the r comma s comma t values at each stationary point. So here if rt minus s square is greater than 0, if rt minus s square is greater than 0 and r less than 0, that point a1 comma b1, corresponding stationary point a1 comma b1 is maximum point. That point is maximum, or simply maxima. that maximum value is called the, that point is maximum point, and the corresponding value of the x at that point is called the maximum value, that is called maxima. And second condition, if rt minus s square greater than 0 and r less than 0, r greater than 0, already less than over, less r greater than 0, then that point is called minimum point or minimum value. That point is called the minimum value, and the value of the function at that point is called the minimum function. And next, third point, if rt minus s square is equal to 0, rt minus s square is equal to 0, then further investigation is required. Further investigation is required. And the fourth condition, here I am writing, fourth condition, if rt minus s square is less than 0, then the point is neither maximum nor minimum. So this is the procedure to find out the maximum or minimum of functions of two variables. Same procedure we can extend to functions of several variables, mean three or more variables also. So simply here the overall explanation is, first we have to find out the first and second order partial derivatives of the given function. Then we have to equal to first order derivatives p and q equal to 0. From that we have to find out the stationary points. At each stationary point we have to check the condition rt minus s square and r value. Okay. Then depending on the rt minus s square and r value, we can give the conclusion that point is either maximum or minimum, or neither maximum nor minimum, or further investigation is required. So this is the explanation about how to find out the maximum and minimum of functions of two variables. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.